My name is Christy Clark Pujara, and I am a professor of history in the Department of African American Studies at UW-Madison. And I'm here today just to talk to you a little bit about the 1969 strike. One of the first things to know about the 1969 Black student strike is to put it in larger historical context. It was part of a national movement. There was a Black student movement that was happening in the 1960s, which was an extension of the modern civil rights movement. It's in the 1950s and 60s that we start to see some success. And so the Black student union strike here at UW was part of that national movement of Black students asserting themselves on campus and demanding places that reflected who they were, that included the Black experience in all areas of study. So like the civil rights movement was a human rights movement, the Black student movement on campus was not just about Black students. It was about making all students from all backgrounds feel comfortable in spaces that had specifically been designed for white men and then white people. And so that's what they were pushing back against. And when we're thinking about places and spaces, I always think of Bascom Hill when I think of the 1969 Black student strike. And it's because there's this really iconic picture of Black and white students. They had thousands of white allies that are standing on Bascom all the way to State Street, right, in protest, right? It was the march that happened mid-February from the university to the Capitol. And in that crowd, you can see the student body, you can see community members, that it wasn't just a few Black students that were agitating for change. It was led by Black students, but it got embraced by a good section, a good significant section of the student body, as well as the community. And if there's a couple of things that I think that's really important to know about the 1969 Black student strike, is that it was part of this much larger social movement, that it depended on white allies. Be an ally means you're willing to risk something that matters to you. It's easy to support something that demands nothing of you. It's a very different thing to support something that could mean your expulsion from school, could mean serving time in jail, right? And so these were allies. These weren't just people that were supportive, but these were people that were allies, willing to risk something. And, you know, their actions were typical of the period. How do you go to school and be successful if you are having difficulty securing housing and getting financial aid? And they were boycotting classes. They were doing that to disrupt the day, but they were also doing that because there were so few classes that centered the experience of people who weren't white or Western. And it was a protest against that, because it sends a very clear message of who's important and who matters, who is worthy of study, who is included in the university curriculum. So they took over buildings, they blocked entryways, they held a couple of marches, and they were met with force. They were met with the force of the university police, of the city police, and then the National Guard. So the National Guard was called in as well. And so these actions went on for about 2 weeks. The students had 13 demands, everything from a Black student center to increasing the number of Black students on campus to admitting the 94 students who had been expelled from UW-Oshkosh, to hiring more Black professors, to increasing the numbers of non-white students on campus. They had an array of demands. They had 13 of them. And in 1970, the then Chancellor Edwin Young approved the Department of African American Studies. And it offered its first classes in 1970, 2020. In the middle of the pandemic, we celebrated our 50 years of existence. This department has educated tens of thousands of students on this campus about Black history, Black art, literature, sociology, You name it. We studied the Black experience from several different angles. It's an interdisciplinary department. The 1969 Black student strike left a real and tangible legacy and tangible department that still very much understands its place on this campus. We're very proud of that history. We are the first department to exist because of student demand. Student demand didn't demand that chemistry or biology or that the history department exist, but they demanded that we exist. And we remind our students that we belong to them. And our allegiance is to the student body because we are of the student body. And it is a history that I am particularly proud to be a part of.